did you feel about the reaction from the fans to Rio?
I'm humbled by it. I didn't expect it.
What did you expect?
I just wanted mystery. I didn't want anybody to know anything about him. I just wanted him to be powerful in his stoicness. So when people liked it, I was shocked by it. I always feel like mystery sells and people just want to know more and more about it. So I just run with it, but I really enjoy it and I appreciate all the love that I get for it.
When you first came in, I didn't know what to, first of all, I was scared. I was like, what's gonna happen? Like, is he gonna kill her? Like, what's gonna happen? You know, but
That's
definitely
crazy.
Saw, you know, the chemistry and everything, you know, between the characters.
When you walked on the screen, I was like, who is that?
Yeah, no, my girlfriend, everybody's attention.
And everything.
My heart dropped. I felt like I was in trouble. I don't know why. Because you always come in to get Beth, like, at birthday parties. And
in the weirdest moments, so I just, like, swoop in.
You're just there. Like, how did you know that she was throwing her son's birthday party that day?
It's super funny to me. First of all, thank you guys. I really appreciate it. I love playing this character. I love, like, swooping in and, like, being 10 steps ahead of everybody. Mm-hmm. I also do love when Beth gets to jump on me too, so it's always kind of like this domino kind of mouse game that we have going.
What was your favorite scene of either season one or two?
Probably the pilot episode where, like, I just come in and show up and, like, I'm sitting on her countertop, and I felt like from day one I knew that I wanted to use Beth. You might look at Beth and think, oh, here's this struggle, you know, tough woman that's just doing what she has to do to feed her family. But what's it different from what Rio's doing? I got a son, I got a family. Yeah. There's no difference in how we do it, it's just on how people view it.
Yeah, exactly.
You couldn't return a text?
Hey, I don't work while on vacation.
That's what I am, work?
Pretty much, yeah.
When Rio told Beth that you guys were just business, how'd you really feel about that? Like, even from, like, Rio's perspective, like, do you really honestly feel like that was the case?
I do and I don't. I felt like from day one it was.
Yeah.
And then he kind of slipped a little bit just with the, the little, the brushing of her hair. In the same way, like, she's enamored by my world, I'm enamored by her straight lace, normal world where she can do things that I normally couldn't. So I like that side of her. And I think he slipped up for a bit and he paid for it at the end of season two.
He's not my problem.
Shut your mouth.
When I saw this, I was not only devastated, but I was like, what is going on? Right. So the game changer, you know, where Beth shoots Rio.
Yeah.
What, I want to know what is going to happen with them, like, moving forward.
That's what I talked to Jenna, you know, the show's creator, about. I was like, how can he ever work with her again?
Exactly.
How can he trust her?
How does he forgive her after
But the
that?
Way they wrote it, it just made perfect sense.
Oh.
If you're making Rio out to be this smart, drug-dealing crime boss, how can he ever trust this woman that shot him? Mm-hmm. It's so good.
So are there any teasers? Come on, you can give us a little bit.
They gave us, like, episodes one through four, like, right before we started filming. And I'm just flipping through those things. It was so good. Season three is just on a whole nother level where everybody's going through something differently and everybody has their own thing. My favorite character thus far this season is what Stan's going through. I won't give anything away, but I'm just like, what? How did he get here?
Yeah.
It's a trip, and I'm really loving it.
One of the things that Rio hasn't done yet that you would want him to do?
I would want to show the audience more danger. I feel like there's danger in Rio just popping up out of nowhere and knowing everything about these women. But I would want them to show how serious it is, because you just walk different and you talk different and you sit differently around somebody that has
absolutely.
A gun.
I want to see more of, like, what you're doing without them around. We don't really get to see, like, what you're up to.
I'd love to see more stuff with my son, to show the dark side and just the normal side of why I'm trying to make all this money and why I'm trying to do what I do.
Mm-hmm. I have a personal question. Tell Who's me. Your favorite good girl?
My favorite good girl?
As Manny, who's your favorite good girl?
It's too tough to answer because I side with all of them for different reasons. With Annie, just because of her craziness and her, like, impulsiveness. With Ruby, because of what she does for her family and who she truly tries to be.
Right.
And with Beth, just because of, like, her legit trying to take over and, like, to have the balls to take on this crime boss. And no matter what people say, like, it's scary. It's a scary world she's in. So the fact that she's doing it is pretty baller to me. So I like it. Thank you guys so much for watching the show. I really appreciate it. Thank you.
Of course. No, thank you. Thank all of you guys. The whole cast, everything, honestly made it very easy for us to, like, be hooked and keep watching. So we're super excited. Excited for season three.
Thank you.
All right, so I want to say thanks to Manny for coming and hanging out with us and giving us the inside scoop of Rio and the Good Girls. So be sure to check out Good Girls season 3 premiering February 16th.